Good morning, everyone. It is Wednesday, let's see, March 18th, and I just wanted to pop in and speak about the coronavirus. What everyone is, the first word out their mouth, what's on the news channels, what's on the feeds when I'm scrolling through social media, it's a work at work and whatever. So first of all, let me give you my disclaimer. No way, shape, or form am I making light of the situation, because as I said in the video before, that I know it's serious, and even one life lost to this disease or any disease is too much. So with that said, okay, I know it's serious. And yes, the government is trying to have us take precautions to keep us safe. And I am doing what's called social distancing, only going out when I need to. And actually my job is allowing us to work from home, which I will talk about that later, or maybe just in another video, I'm not sure. I think this world is way too fearful. They're panicking, and maybe it is my faith and my belief in God that's helping me, keeping me through this, not making me panic and go out and panic buy with the toilet paper and all that, you know. But this has been foretold already in the Bible. Yeah, it may not exactly say coronavirus or anything like that, but the Bible speaks about the end times and the greed of man and women, or just mankind period, and how this world is going to be in the end times. And my thing is, and I know you guys are seeing a whole different side of Michelle right now, you guys don't hear me talk a lot about my religion, but this is just me. Jesus is coming, okay? We don't know where, we don't know when, we don't know what time. Yes, they've been saying this for years and years, but it doesn't make it not true. Anyway, I strongly believe that, and I strongly believe that, you know, the ones that who are going to be left here, if you think you're panic and crazy right now and all this stuff like this, it's gonna be worse when God comes back and take his people on home. I do not wanna be here when that happens, because look at how the world is now. People fighting over toilet paper. I mean, you think if the cure in a Charmin, you know, you would think so, the way people are buying and panic stricken and whatever, and it's just crazy. And my job is allowing me to work from home. I'm so thankful. I'm not gonna be losing any hours or anything like that. I find out everything today. I'm actually going in a little bit later. We all are, and we're gonna just find out how to proceed and everything. So the ones who don't have a laptop, they're gonna give a laptop for them to take home. I fortunately do have a laptop, but I was thinking of, like, I should have told them I didn't so I can not have to use mine, but that would be lying. Anyway, so we are going to work from home starting on Monday. Today's Wednesday, so the rest of this week, they're gonna train us on what to do. And starting on Monday, we're gonna try it for 2 weeks and then go from there. So thank God for that. Anyway, the people who are out and panicking and, I mean, I'm not afraid of what this world is doing. I'm not afraid. It doesn't mean I'm not concerned. Yes, I'm concerned. I want everyone to be safe. I want my family and my friends to be safe, to make sure they're not getting the sickness and to make sure that they have the things that they have. But I come from a family when I was younger that I know how to make struggle meals. So even those struggle meals, some of those struggle meals that we still eat, well, not on a daily basis or anything like that, but sometimes because we actually do like it. Like, for example, number one, cornbread and milk. You guys may think this is gross, but I grew up eating cornbread and milk. And what you do is you make cornbread just like the box of Jiffy says to make it. And then when you're done, you dish out a little bit and you pour milk over it and you eat it like cereal. I absolutely love that. I will eat it for breakfast sometimes. They call it a struggle meal. So a box of Jiffy is like, what, 75 cents, 60 cents, something like that. Anyway, I know I'm not worried about that. But what I was so frustrated about and so upset and still kind of upset is I cannot find toilet paper. I just want to be able to wipe my bum, y'all. That's it. That's all. You know, I don't want to hoard it. Keep stacks and stacks, you know. And what about the parents who have babies? They can't find wipes. And someone told me yesterday that she went to look for wipes for her daughter, and they had this lady, and she had like a whole big case of them. And she said, you know, would it be possible after you pay for it, I can buy one for you? Do you have any kids? The lady's all, no, but you never know. So yeah, stuff like that is so greedy. And like I said before, if you are one of those people who are out panicking, buying, panic buying, and not thinking about the elderly who are out there getting trampled and stuff like that because, you know, they can't get to what they need, shame on you, shame on you. This is just crazy. So yeah, you guys, I mean, the coronavirus, it is serious, and I'm not afraid, I'm not fearful. I mean, I'm not going out there and going to the movies and this and that. I mean, I don't even know if any movies are open. So I'm listening to the government and doing what the government is telling us we should do, right? Because I do want to be healthy. Do I want to get it? No, but I have faith enough to believe that if I was to get it, God would help me through it and I would be healed. And if I wasn't, then that was God's will for me to die and finally go to heaven, you know, get away from all this world. I mean, I don't want that. I'm not speaking it. I'm not, Lord, I'm not asking, don't give me the corona. I mean, I know I want to see you, but not before my time. Anyway, so yes, I have faith in God that if I was to get the coronavirus, I would be healed from it. But all this panicking, it has to stop. It has to stop. I mean, it just goes to show you how crazy this world is. It takes one person to be fearful and the others follow suit. I'm so thankful that I have a strong faith and a belief in God. I just wanted to speak about this coronavirus, and probably because I'm so frustrated how this world is acting. Does it surprise me? No. Is it biblical? Yes. Is it a sign of the times? Yes. You may not think so. You may not have faith in the Bible or whatever, but trust me, it's in there. All this, God knew was going to happen. And so I have faith in God that He's going to take care of me and mine. And if for some reason, I did get the coronavirus, I know God's going to help me through it, and that was His will for me to get it for some reason. I don't know. I don't want it at all, but I'm just saying, if I was to get it, you know, I'm not fearful. So, I mean, all these people going out and buying all this stuff, it's like, what did you do before? Did you not wash your hands before? I mean, you walking around with little nasty hands, you little nasty people, you know? What? I don't get it. And yes, I know they said do it more often. Yes, you know, I get that, but buying out to where the next one shouldn't have, that's greed, that's a sin. I'm not perfect, I'm not, you know, trying to point the finger and say, you know, I'm better than all these people. I'm not, you know, I'm not perfect, but I'm saved, I'm saved. So you guys, if you are out there and you are just one of the ones that are panic buying, just stop and think about, you probably already have a plethora of stuff at home, enough to feed an army, enough to get by for 6 months. You don't need all that. I mean, give some to the neighbor next door that, you know, has kids and can't find diapers and can't find wipes and can't find formula for their babies. Yes, even some formula people are running out, you know. Think about other people. Think about the elderly who go to the store and don't have anything. Think about, I mean, just normal people like me, you know, who can't find toilet paper. Yeah, and who I don't want to stock up. I just want to get my regular, I don't know, I get 32 rolls. And that lasts us a long time. If I had just one of those, I'd be happy. But in spite of that, if someone needed, I would give them some, you know? Think about other people. Don't be so selfish, okay? I mean, America has just become so greedy and fearful. And yeah, if I can get anything across to anybody, and think about other people, stop with the panicking, just do what the government says. I mean, I know the government's not always right. Trust me, I know that. But social distance yourself. I know some people are still going to clubs and doing this and this and that and thinking, oh, it's not gonna touch me. That's when it affects you, when you think you can't be touched. So yes, I'm not saying don't wash your hands or don't go to places. Go only places that's needed. So right now I'm going to work only because we are doing this training. And then once I'm done with that, we're gonna be home. So at that point, I'm going to be in my house. So I'll probably be a lot of more vlogs, I don't know. But I'm going to be in my house, and I'm only going to go out if I need to go to the store. That's how I feel, you guys. Stay safe out there, be smart, be mindful. Don't be selfish, think about other people other than, once you have your family taken care of, don't continue to buy and buy and buy and have all these, you know, your cupboards overflowing and stuff like that. Yeah. Okay, so that's all I have to say about that, you guys. leave me a comment. I'm sure I'll get many comments about what you guys think about this whole situation, and we will discuss it like adults. We can agree to disagree and go from there. Hope you guys have a wonderful, blessed day, and I will see you guys in the next video.